Hi friends, I am Nitin Paul. Today we are discussing about the topic how we can make up a solution in chemistry lab. Usually you will be provided with solution. This is to be made up to 200 ml or to 250 ml. Depending on that one, you will be provided with one standard flask. Here it is 100 ml standard flask. Okay, then it is having a stopper and it is airtight. Then you will be provided with one funnel. This is actually a borosil funnel, so it is very perfect round size, and here also it is perfectly round. So if you are keeping it like this, then it will become airtight. In order to avoid that, otherwise if it is airtight, if you are pouring solution to this way, then the air column inside will push the liquid outside, so some drops will go outside or throw it outside. So we should keep a paper like this in order to provide air circulation. So paper should be folded like this. If it is folding and keeping it like this, it will fall inside. So you should keep it like this only. So very small amount is here folded. So just keep it like this. Then you are provided with a glass rod, and through this glass rod only you should pour the solution. Okay. Then this is distilled water provided in a wash bottle. So this is a solution to be transferred. It is having one stopper. So initially we should wash the stopper because some quantity will be there. So we should wash the stopper very carefully. Okay. We should remove that one. Then this is a solution to be transferred, and we will transfer the solution only through glass rod. You don't pour like this, or don't twist like this and pour, not allowed. You just transfer it carefully like this. This is your glass rod. So through the glass rod, it is kept like this. The end here it is touched like this, not here or to any other place. You just keep here, then keep a considerable small distance above. Okay, just above the funnel you keep it like this, then twist like this. While twisting the bottle, your glass rod also twisted. Okay, now solution is transferred only through glass rod. Okay, then twist back, release. If any solution there, you just allow it to go through the glass rod. Then if it is just pouring like this, then the solution will flow in this way. So in order to avoid that one, you should use a glass rod. So now we keep two methods there. Either you can keep the glass rod here. If the glass rod is very small and if it is not going through that one, then you can keep it like this. Otherwise you can keep the glass rod here. If the glass rod is very lengthy one, if you are keeping it like this, it will fall down. So you can keep it like this. So now you can transfer the solution. While transferring the solution, we should very carefully transfer small amount through the sides. Okay, then if you are pouring through the sides, it will wash the inner surface while going down. So slowly pour the solution through the sides. Don't pour straightly into the bottom place. Okay, now keep it like this. Rotate here. This is actually rinsing. Then transfer through the same glass rod. Through the same glass rod. Okay, go back, just release. So any solution there, it will go through here. It is not allowed to transfer through this way. Then either you can keep the glass rod here or through the inside of the bottle. So you can transfer here. Okay, now you can use the glass rod. Keep it like this. Just rinse this one once more. Transfer it. Okay, release, come back. Now we can once more you can add solution here. Okay, then same process, three times we are rinsing the solution here. Okay, transferring it. Okay, it is transferred. Okay, now you keep the glass rod here, then your solution, the tip of this bottle to be washed. you can wash the tip of this bottle. Okay, then keep it here. Now you can wash the glass rod, tip of this glass rod you can wash. Okay, this to be kept inside this bottle. Then now you should remove this paper. It's not necessary now. You remove this one. Then you just wash the inside of this funnel. Okay, then you should wash the tip of this funnel. Okay, it's over. You keep it like this here. Now the solution is transferred. Now we want to make up the solution up to this mark. Here we are having a mark here. The mark is given here. Up to this one, we should make up the solution. So in order to make up the solution, this is the wash bottle. You can directly transfer the solution to the wash bottle. To that one, you just keep the tip of this wash bottle here. Don't put inside like this. It is not allowed one, because sometimes while releasing the wash bottle, the solution may go back through this wash bottle. So this is allowed. You just keep it here. Transfer the solution up to that mark. Careful. You should be careful while transferring. Okay. Now it is not up to the mark. The solution having upper meniscus and the lower meniscus. So we should carefully fill it up to the lower meniscus, or the lower meniscus should match the marking. So now the tip of this one having some drops, so you can transfer that one very carefully. Okay, just do like this. Then some drops here in this dip you can see here, that you should transfer here. While transferring, you should keep your standard flask like this. It should be on your eye level. So you can transfer it. Okay, one or two drops required. Okay, one more drop is enough. So there is, okay, one more drop required. Okay, now we can see that the lower meniscus is matching this crosshair. Okay, now we can put the stopper here, keep it like this here, then twist like this. Then in between you should release this stopper. Sometimes some solutions gas may develop, so it will make the disturbance inside or may crack this bottle. In order to avoid that one, it is a usual practice. Shake like this, remove. Shake like this. Okay, now your solution is ready. It is made up to 100 ml. Now we want to transfer to 20 ml. We should transfer to our conical flask. It is washed one. So how we can transfer that one? That's the pipette provided to you. So first we should rinse the solution while taking this. This one inside some water there, so we should rinse the pipette. So sometimes if my fingers are dry, it is difficult for me to control this one. So just I will touch here, then doing like this, it is not perfectly dry, it is not perfectly wet, so I can control it. Now I can immerse here. Instead of keeping like this, you can come here, keep it like this. So in this way you can lock this. So okay, I'm just immersing that one, then locking here. Okay, this is enough for rinsing. Very small amount, enough. You keep it like this only. Don't keep your fingers here or your palm here. You can't keep like this, because it will make some temperature difference, so volume may change. So just here on marking there up to this point, you just rinse like this. This keep only here. Don't touch at this end or to this bulb. So release the solution to the sink. Okay. Same thing you do once more. Solution, then lock it like this. If you are locking like this, then you can prevent the pipette is moving like this. If the pipette is moving upward and while you are sucking, what will happen? The entire solution will come to your mouth. So in order to avoid that one, you should lock like this with your finger. Once more we are rinsing this one like this. None of the chemicals, nothing is coming to your fingers. Nothing happening, it is not coming to your fingers, just coming up to this level. So you should keep a balance there. The next one, you should transfer 20 ml to that bottle. This is actually the marking, okay. So you just keep it like this, just to take 20 ml. Yes, you just to keep it like this. Before doing all this, while you are pipetting, your conical glass should be ready. Now you can transfer it, you keep it vertical. If you are standing like this, the flow will be very slow. If you are keeping it like this, flow will be fast. So it is going there, okay. So while pipetting, you should use your this finger only, don't keep it like this. Keep it like this, okay. Now the solution is coincide. Now what you should do, the tip also having something. So you should do like this, 1, 2, 3. 3 times you just touch, you release. Your solution is ready here. For titration, 20 ml is transferred to this conical glass. Then you should keep your pipette safe. Okay, your bottles are there, you can remove all this to a safe place. Okay, now this is your standard solution. This is the solution transferred to a conical flask. Now we are having your solution or link solution to be taken in burette. Now, so you are having a burette here. This is your burette. Here you should check the stopper. If it is released, you just close it. Sometimes in this burette, you can have the, you can see like this here the stopper. This is the cork used to tighten the stopper. If it is loose, you just keep it like this and tight it. Release, tight it. So it should be like this. It should be close to this one. Otherwise, sometimes the solution will leak through this way. So it's already done like that. So you are having this burette. Now how we can rinse the burette? So before taking the solution, we should rinse burette. So take it like this. This is actually a standard solution. Sorry, this is a solution here. This is a standardized solution. So before transferring to the burette, we should just rotate like this. So make it uniform. Okay. Now you transfer to your burette. Very small amount is required. Transfer here. Okay, this is enough for doing the rinsing process. So keep it like this. Don't keep your thumb here and close it. Not necessary. You keep it like this. Okay, so just a balancing act. You should keep it like this. Then don't allow the solution to flow this way. Now, okay, just to rotate it. This is enough. Now you're just closing it and rotating. Don't do like this. It's not allowed. Chemicals should come to your hand. It's not allowed. So like this, you just remove that solution. So while removing that, the tip also will be rinsed. Usually we will do the rinsing process 3 times. Okay, like this, we should do 3 times, 2 times more. Then, once more we can do that. So it is transferred to your burette, very small amount. Then keep the burette like this. To the sink. The mouth of the burette should come to the sink. So then nothing will fall to the ground. If you keep it like this, it is safe. I'm not keeping it closed. It is open. Just rotate it like this. Keep it parallel. Rotate it. Is enough. Then allow the solution to drain. Okay. Once more, we should do this. Okay. Then how we can make up the solution to the beard? Now you transfer this. Carefully you transfer this. It is transferred here. Okay. Then here some air bubbles, air gap is there. We don't allow the air gap to be there because while doing dilatation, the air gap will be filled, but the reading will be marked, but the solution would come to your conical flask because it will be used to fill the air gap. So first of all, first itself, we should remove this air gap. Okay, it is removed. Now you should keep the lower meniscus up to this zero mark. Okay, this is coming to the zero mark. Then the lower meniscus is coming to the zero mark. Now how we can read the thick beard? You should keep the beard like this with two fingers. You should hang it like this, so it will be vertical. Otherwise, if you are keeping it like this, we can't assure that it is vertical, so the reading may change. So keep it like this, two fingers, use only two fingers, keep it vertical. Then up to your eyes, it should come to the level of your eyes. Then read it like this. Okay, it is zero. After titration also you should read like this. Just to keep the burette here, read it like this only. Okay, with the two fingers only you should hang it, then read it properly. Otherwise the reading may change on each try. Okay. Then the solution is ready for titration. So while keeping the solution here, it is there. Solution is there. Then solution in your standard conical flask is ready. If indicator is required, you should add that one. Then keep it like this. Then you should be locked like this. Okay, now it is locked. It is locked here. If you are keeping the burette like in a higher level and you keep the solution, it may go like this. Sometimes the solution may fall and will loose. So you should keep it like this only. Here it should come here in this way. It is safe. So solution won't go anywhere. Now we can keep your fingers here. Just rotate like this very slowly. So we can very slowly raise the solution to the conical flask. And then you should rotate like this. So we can visualize any change inside the solution. And well, in order to visualize the change, you should keep a porcelain tile, a white surface below this. Okay, then only you should do this. Now you can clearly see any changes here. Here, no need of looking like this. The solution is below there. So keep like this. Be straight. Do your titration. Very small quantity you can transfer here. Then you can do your titration.